Today I don't feel like doing anything.
Okay, meat curries, very simple. The three cardinal ingredients for any meat curry: onion, ginger, garlic. It's just a mantra you've got to learn. If you want to cook meat, you've got to have onion, ginger, and garlic, which frankly can be a pain. Onions you tend to have in. Ginger and garlic was always a hurdle for me because it means you have to go to a specialist shop and buy it and prep it, and I'd rather just be a vegetarian than do that. But can I show you this amazing shortcut? And it really is something that has integrity in my view. I'm gonna hide the make. Crushed garlic and ginger mix. It's frozen cubes of it. And look, these are not sappy little, you know, ice tray size. These are serious, you know, golden nuggets of joy. And in fried onions in a pan. Have a look in the pan. Yep, I've already fried them. At whatever stage, chuck two or three of these ginger and garlic mixed cubes in. So you get them this size, you're gonna get them from an Indian shop. So venture in there, get into the freezer compartment and buy some. What's great about them is that they don't have any vinegar in. They don't have any of those acidic preservatives. They are purely ground ginger, garlic, and water. And so they are not going to curdle your dish in any way and add those flavors that do not belong in Indian cooking, which is the flavor of vinegar, really. Okay, so we fry those together, and as soon as they are baby brown, we go in with, if you want it to be a brown curry, you go in with tomatoes. So a tin of tomatoes, or two tins of tomatoes if you want a lot of sauce. So I'm just gonna wait for these to cook, and then I will come back to you.
Feel like